So what is meant by profit center? Profit center is a tool in the new GL concept. Okay, like we are creating, based on profit center, we are creating financial statement for internal reporting purpose. Even company code level also, we are creating financial statement for external reporting purpose. When you want to create the profit center, first you want to configure controlling area. Even yesterday we discussed regarding controlling area. So what is meant by controlling area? Controlling area is highest hierarchy in the CO. For example, whatever objectives you want to do in the CO, first you need to activate in the controlling area level. Later you can do that objective. For example, first when you want to do in the profit center, first you can create this controlling area. Later you can activate profit center in the controlling area level. Let us see. Yesterday we did. We'll just open SAP. I will show you. One second, it's going controls. Yeah, so let's go to everyone. Once again, you can see this controlling area. See this one? Yeah, go to SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG. SAP reference IMG. And select here controlling, general controlling, and organization, and maintain controlling area, and click on your maintain controlling area. And click on your position. So what is your controlling area? GMCA. Yesterday we created GMCA controlling area. This one, GM controlling area. This one we created. So first, for example, let it be in the CO objectives. Example, profit center is a, I mean, previously profit center also CO objective before new GL concept. Even cost center, CO objective, internal order CO objective, product costing CO objective. Like this activities, when you want to do in the CO, first you can create this controlling area, then you can activate particular objective, then you can start your work. Otherwise, system will not accept. Okay? And it's throw the error message. So when I want to do profit center, first you can create controlling area, then you can activate controlling area. How I can activate? Example, select this GMOC, activate components. And see here I can activate profit center accounting yesterday. Profit center accounting, even cost center accounting activated, order management, if you want you can activate. Like different things is available. Okay, here profit center activate, then you can do the profit center creation. You just click on your save and back. Yeah, the next step, activate controlling area. Activate controlling area. For example, why I want to do this step? Everyone, you just catch the point. Why I want to do this step? For example, in the SAP, lot of controlling areas is available. So whatever you are creating profit center, under which controlling area you are creating, so you need to activate. So when I activate controlling area, okay, the system will understand, oh okay, this person is creating profit center under particular controlling area. So that is the reason first you need to activate controlling area. For example, what is the path? This is the path: SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master data or master record, and profit center, set controlling area. So this profit center you want to create which controlling area? Okay, this when you want to create the profit center, under which controlling area? That controlling area you need to activate here. That is the reason we want to do this step. Okay, so go to SAP menu, like accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master records, profit center. See this one, set controlling area. This is the one. You just double click on this set controlling area. Very simple. Profit center, under whatever controlling area you want to create, first you can enter that controlling area. Example, let it be, what is my controlling area? My controlling area is GMCA. Under this GMCA, I need to create profit center. So I need to activate this GMCA. So you can enter this GMCA. What is meant by GMCA? When you want to know, click on here this button. See here, lot of controlling areas is available. You can go to your controlling area, GMCA, GM controlling area. Very simple. Otherwise you can enter GMCA here, then click on here. Okay, that's it. The system will understand next whatever activity you are doing, that step under comes GMCA. Okay, the next, define profit center standard hierarchy. Everyone, what is meant by define profit center standard hierarchy? Okay, I will go in the SAP system, I will explain you. So how to create define profit center standard hierarchy? This is the path, like SPRO, financial accounting new, general ledger accounting new, master data, profit center, defines profit center standard hierarchy. Very, very important. Go there. SPRO, enter. SAP reference IMG. And select here, financial accounting new. General ledger, master data, profit center, this one, define profit center standard hierarchy in controlling area. So what is the T code on this? How to find the T code? go to additional information, additional information, display keys, IMG activities. IMG activities. The last four digit is T code. You just double click on here. And click on your position. Click on your position. Enter here your controlling area. What is our controlling area? GM, CA. Press enter. CR. This is your controlling area. And this is here your hierarchy. Here, set here any name. It may be numerical or it may be alphabets. Example, let it be, I am set one name, GMCA underscore pro profit center. So why I want to set this hierarchy? For example, under this hierarchy I want to create profit center. Okay, press enter and save. Everyone, press enter and save. For example, everyone, you just understand the process of profit center. For everyone, you just catch the configuration strategy. First, you can create controlling area. Controlling area. This controlling area you can assign to company code. You can understand this strategy you need to tell in the interview. Company code. And under this controlling area, you need to assign hierarchy. Hierarchy. This one. Which one? Just now we are doing, right? Hierarchy. Okay. This is the one. Under this hierarchy, you want to create profit center groups. Profit center groups. And under this profit center groups, we need to create profit centers. Profit center. See this one. First, you can create controlling area, then you can activate profit center. This controlling area you can assign to company code. Under this controlling area, we need to set one hierarchy. Means you can set any name. Under that name, we need to create profit center groups. Why we want to create profit center group? Profit center groups we are creating reporting purpose. Example, see here, I can create Hyderabad group. Under Hyderabad, I created two profit center. Let's imagine this Hyderabad is profit center group. And under this Hyderabad, I can create two profit center. One is Balanagar. And one is Amirpet profit center. So when I go to Balanagar, I will get Balanagar reports. When I go to Amirpet, I will get Amirpet reports. But when I go to Hyderabad level, I will get both report at a time. When I go to Hyderabad level, I will get both reports, even Balanagar report and Amirpet report. Okay. This is profit center group means this is highest hierarchy of the profit center, we are creating reporting level. Okay, just imagine this is the Hyderabad is the profit center group, and this is the profit center and this is the profit center. When I go to Balanagar profit center, and I will get only Balanagar information. When I go to Amirpet profit center, I will get only Amirpet information. But when I go to Hyderabad profit center group level, I will get both information at a time. So that is the reason we need to create profit center group. Okay, under this, under profit center group, we need to create profit centers. Profit center may create area wise and may create functional wise, may create product wise. Example, we are creating profit center area wise. So for example, this under this controlling area, we are creating profit center, right? So this is indirectly this profit center assigned to company code. Indirectly this profit center assigned to company code. This is the very, very important. In the interview, you need to say this configuration strategy. First, we are creating controlling area. Under controlling area, we are set one name as a standard hierarchy. Under this hierarchy, we are creating profit center group. Under this group, we are creating profit center. It means it is indirectly assigned to the company code. Otherwise, you can note it down. Configuration hierarchy, configuration strategy of the profit center. Everyone, you just note it down. Done.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. And so this standard hierarchy is completed. Now the profit center standard hierarchy for controlling area. Later, define standard hierarchy. Define standard hierarchy means this is profit center groups. This is, we need to create profit center groups. For example, see here, in the profit center group means here we want to design one tree. Okay, let it be. So where I want to design SPRO, let us see here. John, are you able to understand?
Yes, I'm following. No problem.
Yeah. And everyone, Harish, Raj, Rajkumar, everyone, are able to understand? Any doubts?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. Any doubts, you just feel free to ask me at any point of time. Okay. Don't fear. We are all one team. Like, feel as a one team. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. And so how to create this profit center group? Profit center group means we need to create standard hierarchy. We need to design one tree. Example, okay? And see here, define profit center standard hierarchy. This is the path. SPRO, financial accounting new, and general ledger accounting, master data and profit center define standard hierarchy and go there and save and back here. See your second step, same path, second step, define standard hierarchy. See, you just catch the point here. Here I can set one name, right? CMCA. Here I can set one name, any name you can set. Under this name we are creating profit center groups like tree. Go there, you just double click on here. See here, that name is displayed here automatically. That name is displayed here. Whatever name you can set there, that name displayed here. This is hierarchy. Under this hierarchy we are creating profit center groups. Okay, let it be. And example, GM profit center standard hierarchy. Then click on your enter. See everyone, you just catch the point. We are creating one tree and select here GMCA, select here GMCA, click on here lower level, click on here lower level, and GM10 underscore any name, GM10 underscore and PG. What is meant by PG? GM10 profit center groups, and enter and click on here GM10 PG profit center group. PG means profit center group, and click on your same level and GM20 underscore PG and GM20 profit center group. And press enter and select here GM10, click on here lower level, okay. And we are creating groups. I am creating two groups. One is Hyderabad group, like do one thing, GM10 HYD, GM10 Hyderabad profit center group. Press enter, click on your GM10 HYD, then click on your same level GM10 MUM Mumbai, GM10 Mumbai profit center group, then click on your enter and save. This is the groups. If you want to create group, you can create GM20 also, very simple. Then click on your lower level, example, click on your lower level and GM20 underscore like HYD. What is this? GM20 Hyderabad profit center group. Enter. What is this group? When I go to Excel, see here, I explained. This is the profit center groups. Under this I can create Balanagar group and Amirpet. This is the profit center group. Under this group I can create Balanagar profit center and Amirpet profit center, like this. Okay, see here, click on your save and back, save and back. This is the groups. Okay, I will show you what happened here. See, once again you can understand this configuration strategy. First I can create controlling area, then activate profit center. Later you can create hierarchy, means you need to set any name. Under this name we are creating profit center groups, like any groups, Hyderabad group, Mumbai group, any groups we are creating. Under this group we are creating profit center. Under this group we are creating profit center. So the very important, how to create profit center, very. So why I want to do all the steps, I did all the steps for creating profit center, very important. Okay, and how to create profit center? SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master records, profit center, individual processing, and create. Very important. This process is very important. Go to SAP / and go back. SAP menu and accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, master records, and profit center, and individual processing. What is the T code? KE51. KE51 is the T code. And create for profit center. You just double click on this KE51 and enter here any 6 digit. Up to, system will accept up to 6 digit. Okay, for why I want to enter any 6 digit, up to 6 digit, this is for system identification purpose. Example, I am entering here GM, example GM 100. I entered 5 digits. It may be numerical or it may be alphabets. System will accept up to 6 digit. Okay, and I enter GM10, press enter button in the keyboard, then write the description like Amirpet profit center. Profit center here, Amirpet profit center. Then who is the responsible person? If you want to give responsible person, you can give. Example, Mr. Vishnu is the responsible person. Okay, then this profit center belongs to which department? This profit center belongs to finance department. Okay, and this profit center belongs to which group? Profit center group. See here, here we need to assign profit center group. Example, select your profit center group. See here displaying GM10 Mumbai profit center group, GM10 Hyderabad profit center group. Yeah, different groups here displaying. Okay, example, I am selecting GM10 HYD Hyderabad profit center group. Then here we can assign segment. This profit center belongs to which segment? Example, we are created different segments. See here, GM OPP cement, PPP cement, steels and rods. You can select any segment, means this profit center belongs to which segment? You need to ask your client for these details. I am creating one profit center. This profit center belongs to who is the responsible person? This profit center belongs to which department? This profit center belongs to which group? This Amirpet is in Mumbai or in Hyderabad, in Paris, where it is? This comes under which group? So you need to ask your client. And which segment? Your segment. Example, select here this segment. Press enter and save. And save. When you click on your save, you must activate. You must activate. Without activation, this profit center never work. Okay, then click on here activate. See this one, profit center GM100 has been created. Example, one more profit center I am creating. Listen careful. Enter here any up to six digit. It may be numerical or it may be alphabets. Example, I am entering here GM200. GM200. Press enter button in the keyboard and write the profit center name. Example, Balanagar profit center. Profit center. Profit center. And this profit center, who is responsible person? Okay, example, Mr. Rajkumar. And this Balanagar profit center belongs to which department? Example, finance department. And this Balanagar department and comes under which group? And click on this. This comes under Hyderabad group. GM10 Hyderabad profit center group. And this profit center belongs to which segment? And you can select any segment. We are created different segments at the time of enterprise structure. We are created these segments. Example, let it be steels. This is steel segment. Then click on your save. Then click on your save, then OK, then click on your activate, then click on your activate. And do one thing, I will show you, no problem. Okay, do one thing,
okay.
Go there, example for your understanding, go there, go back. This is for create, right? And this is for display. You just click on your display. What is the display? Whatever created, KE51 for your doubt, I am explaining. Listen careful. KE51 for create, and whatever created in the KE51, you can display it here. KE53. You enter KE53 and enter here your profit center. Example GM200. Press enter. Then click on your company code. See here. This company code automatically assigned. Why automatically assigned? When I go to Excel, see here, what is our configuration strategy? What is our, for I am creating this profit center under this controlling area. This controlling area is assigned to profit center. So it means this controlling area is assigned to company code. Sorry, listen carefully. Sorry. This is controlling area. Under this controlling area, I am creating profit center. So this controlling area I assign to company code. It means this is indirectly assigned to profit center and company code. That is the reason it came automatically. Understood?
Yes, got it,
right? Even if you want to address communication, yes. History, you can create, no problem. Okay, history also comes automatically.
Okay,
got it.
Yes, we got it.
And one more profit center you can create. You just I'm double click on this KE51 and enter here in up to 5 digit. Example, I'm entering here GM300. Press enter and write the description. Write the description and example any profit center, Andheri profit center, Andheri profit center. Andheri profit center. Who is the responsible person? Mr. Madhu. Which department? Finance department. Which profit center group? This is comes under Mumbai. This is comes under Mumbai profit center group. Example. And click on your segment. Enter here any segment. Example, this is the segments. OPP cement, like PPC cement. Press enter button in the keyboard. When I go to company code, see this will pick automatically. Why? Because this company codes I assigned to controlling area. Okay, see here it is displaying this controlling area CM GMCA under this. See this one under this controlling area. I created profit center. This controlling area I assigned to this company codes. Okay, even if you want to enter this address details, you can enter if it is required. Otherwise, you can keep it as it is. Then communication, like, you know, for example, here I wrote responsible person, right? Responsible person, Mr. Madhu. Communication means, like, you know, Madhu, what is the telephone number, what is the printer number, what, which language they are using, like this type of information you can enter here, communications. Okay, then history will come, who created SAP user, when created, when they are changed, like this type of information will come here. Okay, clarified? Navin, click on your save and back. Save.
Yes, I will.
And activate. Yes, Navin, please go ahead. No problem.
No, doubt has been clarified.
Clear, right? Okay.
I have just a question.
Yes, please, John.
My question is that if you can come back, if you can enter for this this profit center, and I will show in the first screen. If you can click enter.
Yes.
If you click enter, we have a cell which is mentioned analysis period.
Okay. Yes,
we have to set up the period from one date to 9999.
Okay.
So my question is that when we set up, when we create the controlling area, and if I remember, for example, we said that the company begin at 1999.
This is the one, right?
And
you are asking, this is the one?
Yeah, exactly.
Very good. See this one.
January.
See this one. This is analysis period from date and to date. For example, let it be, I enter 01/01/2020 and to date, when I enter 01 and 02/2020, when I enter here, whatever profit center you are creating, that profit center works only 2 months, only the first month and only second month. When I enter here, means, for example, this is the, for example, let it be, one example I'm telling you, in your office, one contract department is joined. That contract department is worked only 6 months. Jan to June. So you need to enter Jan to June only. Like same way, this profit center, whatever profit center you are creating, GM400, that profit center applicable which period? This is from date to date. When I enter here, example, when I enter here, 01-06-2020, what happened? This whatever profit center you are creating GM40, this analysis I will get only 01-01-2022-01-06-2020. Got it my point? For example, this profit center work in the long time, you can give very, like 999, means it is a very long period. This profit center work in the long period, analysis period. Got it my point?
But my concern,
but my concern is in the beginning period. For example, when we set up, or when we say that the company begins at 1999, and we
have John, you just casual one. Not only 1999, this is the year, you can give any year. Okay.
It's not, I understand, that's not the point. The point is just in the beginning. We say that the 1st of January. Okay. For this point, I got it.
Okay.
But in the beginning, for example, when we said that...
I will tell you one thing. Actually, for example, if you create profit center product level, example, I'm creating vans and I'm creating bikes. Okay. But this van, my target is this van I manufacture only one year. Later, after 1 year, I don't want to manufacture. Okay. So I am creating profit center under this vans. So I created this profit center under this van. I can manufacture this vans only 1 year. After 1 year, I don't want to create. Like after 1 year, I don't want to manufacture the vans. Only 1 year I can create. So under this, and based on the product, I am creating profit center. Based on the product, I'm creating profit center. So 1 year only, right? So my analysis profit center period also 1 year. So 01-01-2020 to 31st-12-2020. I manufacture this vans only 1 year. So my analysis period also 01-01-2022 31st-12-2020. This is from date and to date. Means particular profit center. So particular profit center, what is your analysis period? So for practicing purpose, I am giving like long date. Okay. So for example, this period, this profit center, example, this van I can work in the lifelong from end. I can manufacture these vans from up to end date. So what is the year I can give? Example, 31st-12-99-99. This is the end date. It's a long date actually. Got it my point?
Yes.
From date and to date. Okay. If I give only 1 month, this analysis will get only 1 month. If you give end date, 99.99 means I think mostly 100 years.
Okay. That's fine.
Yeah. Example, write it here. Example, GM, any name, Kukatpalli Profit Center.
Thank you.
Then click on your save and activate. All right, do one thing. I will show you one thing. Here you can go to Profit Center groups. You can go to Profit Center groups. I will show you one thing. SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG, and select here financial accounting, new financial accounting, general ledger accounting, master data, profit center, and define profit center standard hierarchy. You just double click on this. This is our groups, right? This is our groups.
Yes.
This is standard hierarchy, profit center standard hierarchy. Under standard hierarchy, I have two company codes, GM10 and GM20. Under this GM10, I created two groups. One is Hyderabad group, one is Mumbai group. Under Hyderabad group, I have three profit centers. One is Amirpet profit center, Balanagar profit center, and Kukatpalli profit center. Just now I created. Under this Mumbai, I have one profit center, Andheri profit center. Got it, my point? Everyone?
Yes.
This is standard hierarchy. This is the name. This name I assigned to controlling area. Under this hierarchy, I created the groups. Under this group, I created profit centers.
Okay.
Got it, my point? Click on your save and back. This is the one. Controlling area, hierarchy, profit center group, profit center. This controlling area assigned to company codes. It means this profit center indirectly assigned to company codes. And yeah, do one thing. When you want to create profit center, when you want to create profit center, click on here KE51. Okay. When you want to change profit center, for example, you need to change description, you need to change segment, any changes is occurred. What can I do? You just double click on these changes, double click on KE52, 51 is the create, 52 is changes. You just double click on this, and which profit center you need to change. Example, GM100, press enter. You can change anything. Example, name and long date, responsible person and department. Basically, this profit center belongs to marketing department. By mistakely, I entered finance department. So I replace finance to marketing. Changes. Example, I am telling marketing department. Then click on your save. Then activate. Got it, my point? Why I want to change? Example, see here, now is the marketing. Any changes, if you want to change anything like name, long date, responsible person, department, profit center, group, okay, like that. And click on your save and back. This is just for display, just for the display. KE53, display means, example, enter here GM100, just for display. What is the information you entered, like this, just for display. Okay, then go back, click on your GM200, press enter, just for display. Okay. And delete. If you want to delete any profit center, you can delete. For example, you just double click on this, click on your delete, and I am deleting. If you want to delete, enter here GM400. You just catch the point, note it down. Everyone, write the note, write one note. If you create any master data, if you create any master data, note it down. If you create any master data, Example, profit center, GL, vendor, any master data. If you create any master data, the system will accept delete. System will accept delete before accounting entry posting. Before accounting entry posting, if you post accounting entry, next point you can write, if you post accounting entry on particular master data, if you post accounting entry on particular master data, the value is updated that is the reason system will not accept it to delete. System will not accept it to delete the master data. Sunil, are you write the notes? Understood?
Yes.
So what need to, everyone listen careful. So what is my words means, any master data before accounting entry posting, system will accept for delete. Okay. Once you can post accounting entry, the value should be updated on master data. That is the reason system will never accept for deleting. Okay, got it my point, John?
Yes. All right.
Yeah, and that is write as a note, note. Okay, if, for example, how to delete whatever. Go back. If you want to delete any, click on here. Delete. If whatever profit center you want to delete, enter profit center, press enter, then click on here, mark as a delete. So I don't want to delete, just I am showing how to delete. Can you click on a mark as delete? It's go to delete. And display changes. What is meant by display changes? Basically, do one thing. GM 100, I changed like finance department to marketing department. Did you remember? Everyone go on mute, listen class carefully. And here in the changes FE52, this GM 100, I change finance department to marketing department. Okay. And what is mean by this option? Display changes. Whatever changes you did, that changes displayed here. Example, you just double click on here. And click on your profit center. Which profit center you want to see? Example, I want to see GM 100. Then press enter. Click on here all changes. See here, this is the old value is called finance, the new value is marketing. From date to to date, what I changed department, and when you changed, this is the date. When you changed the date, what field you changed, department, and valid from and to. This is the jumped out. This is the from and to, and language English, and old name and new name. do one thing. For example, do one thing. I will tell you. I'm going to change this KE52. Everyone, catch the point here. You just click on your KE52, and let's. I'm doing changes. You just click on your KE52 and enter your GM200. Press enter. What is my responsible person? Mr. Rajkumar, right? Due to some reason, Mr. Rajkumar is resigned in my office. So I can change my responsible person, right? So Rajkumar to, I enter here Mr. Sunil. Sunil. Then click on here save. Then activate. Then go back. So what is this? Display changes. You just double click on display changes. What is the profit center? GM200. Press enter. Then click on here all changes. See here, when you changed 23-9-2020, which field you changed? Person responsible. And what is the old name? Old name is Rajkumar. The new name is Sunil. Changes, profit center, display changes. Got it, my point? KE51, create profit center. KE52, change profit center. KE53, display. KE54, delete profit center. 6 KEA, display changes. Anyone, any doubt here? Renuka, are you there? Any doubts?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
No,
sir, clear.
No doubt, right? Tomorrow I will start for document splitting. Okay, tomorrow I will start for document splitting. So profit center is complete. Tomorrow I will start for document splitting. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thanks for joining.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Yeah, Harish.
Punam.
Yes. Yes, John, please tell me.